everyone. Welcome back to integralcalc.com. We're going to be doing another partial derivatives problem today. This one is f of xy equals e to the 2 times e to the xy. Now with this problem, a couple things. The first thing that we're going to notice is that we have two quantities that are multiplied together. E squared is 1 and e to the xy is another. So we're going to want to use product rule because since we're taking derivatives of this function here and we have two things multiplied together, we need to use product rule in order to take the derivative of this function. So I've gone ahead and written out product rule here, and because we have product rule, the first thing that we'll need to do is assign f of x to one of our quantities and g of x to another of our quantities. It doesn't matter which ones you pick, so I just went ahead and went in order and assigned f of x to our e squared here and g of x to our e to the xy. So now that we've picked our quantities, we can go ahead and start taking our partial derivatives. So we're going to need to take the partial derivative with respect to both x and with respect to y. So we're just going to go through term by term in the product rule formula to take the partial derivative with respect to x first. So first thing our product rule formula tells us is that we're going to need the derivative of f of x. So we go here and we look, we have f of x equals e squared. So taking the derivative of e squared, well, e squared is simply a constant because e is a constant number. E is something like 2.7 whatever. So when we square that, we're just going to get a constant number. Of course, the derivative of any constant is simply zero, so we go ahead and we put zero here as the first component of our partial derivative with respect to x. Then our product rule formula tells us we need to add in g of x here. So we go ahead and we take this e to the xy and we multiply it here in our partial derivative. Then we will add to that f of x, which we pull straight from here, this e squared, untouched. And now we're going to need to add in the derivative of g of x. So we go ahead and add that in there. But that is the most complicated part of our problem because we need to use chain rule to get the derivative of g of x. So go ahead and put chain rule here. And if you have any trouble with either product rule or chain rule, you can go and look at those sections on my website, but I'll just briefly recap here. So chain rule, to take the derivative of our function here, g of x, well, first of all, since we're taking the partial derivative of f with respect to x, we need to take the derivative of g of x with respect to x. So in that case, we're treating x as the variable and y as the constant. So imagine here that y is a constant. That would make it much like a coefficient on our x term right here. So if y were, for example, the number 4, right, a constant number, then this would look like e to the 4x instead of just e to the 4. So if we have e to the 4x, the derivative of that would be 4e to the 4x, right? We would bring that 4 down. Well, in this case, 4 is representing our y term, so we're going to end up with y e to the xy instead of 4e to the 4x. So that's how we get y e to the xy down here. We have to take the derivative of this inside exponent here instead of just leaving it as e to the xy as we would if we just had e to the x. We have to bring that y term down in front. So knowing that, we can get the final answer for our partial derivative with respect to x. We just simplify. This first term over here, since it's multiplied by 0, just goes away completely. And we're left with just the e squared, which is like a coefficient because it's a constant number, so it goes in front, y e to the xy. So let's go ahead and move on to our partial derivative with respect to y. So again, taking the derivative of f of x, because that's the first thing in our product rule formula, And again, even when it's with respect to y, the derivative of e squared, a constant number, will be 0. Then we go ahead and add in g of x, which is simply e to the xy. And then we add to that f of x. We have f of x here in our product rule formula, so we add in this e squared. And then we take the derivative of g of x. So again, here, the tricky part, taking the derivative of g of x, but this time with respect to y instead of with respect to x, because this is the partial derivative with respect to y. So when we take the partial derivative with respect to y, we treat y as the variable and x as the constant. So again, same thing. If x is a constant here, that means it's like a number. So, you know, we can call this, instead of e to the xy, we can call it e to the 5y. And we're taking the derivative with respect to y. So that 5 comes down in front like a coefficient. And we have 5e to the 5y. But 5 is representing our x. We just go ahead and replace that x. We replace the 5 with the x, and we have xe to the xy is the way that I like to think about it. So that is our partial derivative of g of x with respect to y. And so our final answer for that problem is e squared xe to the xy. So that's it. Those are our final answers. I hope that helped, and I will see you guys next time. Bye!